ที่สู่ความรักของผมดูได้ปวดปวดกันไหมกับใจของหญิงรักของผมไม่มีการอ้างอิงที่สุดความจริงก่อนรักผม
Hi everyone, welcome to Pal to Tech. We're kicking things off this week first and foremost with a product review. Also, from now on, I'm going to give an official letter grade. To products that I review at the end of each video. Any company sending in a product to this channel will not know the final review grade until the video is launched and published live for all of you. A means outstanding and well worth the money. For example, the 16mm Fujinon lens. That's an A. B means very good and a solid investment for you. C means average, may or may not be worth the money, so, you know, give some consideration before buying. D means very poor, not worth the money, and really won't add any value. Well, F means not only is it not worth the money, it is a complete waste of your time and a complete failure as a product. For example, the MacBook Pro 2018 with this awful, god-awful keyboard, which I'm not going to get into right now because I'm in a good mood today. Let's get into the review. Tourbox creates hardware controllers for various software programs on your computer, such as Photoshop, Lightroom, Capture One, video editors, and so forth. They were kind enough to send us this Tourbox device for examination and review. But just like always, this review is completely independent. Tourbox is not paying me to do this review. For myself personally, keyboard shortcuts are absolutely the fastest way to get things done on a computer. It's much faster than having to click a mouse and do the same task. However, with photo and video editing programs, because you have user interface controls on the screen, such as sliders, dials, timelines, and needing to expand and contract circles and so forth, I'm always on the lookout for any device that can speed up the editing workflow and allow me to get the job done faster. I already have a graphics tablet, hardware programmer keyboards with clickety-click keys, and then this shuttle thing, best of them all, the IBM Model M. It weighs about as much as a Winnebago, but you know what? Best keyboard ever made. When I started opening up the box of yet another interface device, I was skeptical. But let's take a look at it. It comes with a pretty nice instruction book with pretty color pictures written in a zillion languages. Something else I found refreshing was that they included an extra long USB-C cord. That was a nice touch because the placement of the desk and your computer may require a longer cord. The unit itself is actually pretty heavy and solid. And at first glance, this thing looks like an Xbox game controller on steroids. There's three sections to this thing. The rotating section, something called the Prime 4 section, and an area called the Kit section. Each of these three sections is sort of a grouping of controls of how you're able to manipulate them. So for example, instead of just pressing this button here, you can also hold that down and press that button to do something different. Yes, it's awesome that you can customize any possible way that you can imagine, but at the same time, there are so many options, it can almost feel overwhelming. To help with this, Tourbox offers presets. These are also great starting points since you can then further fine-tune these presets to your specific needs. To get this thing recognized by your computer, you need to install the Tourbox control software. And if you're on a Mac, you also need to install a special Mac OS driver. Thanks, Apple. This allows the device to completely take over various accessibility functions, such as using the mouse and so forth on your Mac. The Mac installation steps they provided were extremely easy to follow and helpful. If installing this thing on my computer would have taken me more than 5 minutes because of goofy software, then into the trash it would have gone. I have no patience for bad software in 2020. As you hover your mouse over the various choices, you actually see an image of the Tourbox showing you what's what. And if you want to assign a button, let's say the Tour button, which happens to be this button right here, you simply click on it. There's two ways to enter shortcuts. One, you could actually do a search. You could say export And there it is, there's your choices. Or you can click right here and do a keyboard combination like, you know, Shift Command V, and there's that. And it'll automatically assign that keyboard stroke to that shortcut button. You can add your presets here either through downloading from the website or you can create your own. And once you add a preset, you can link it to a program that you have on your computer. Tourbox does already come pre-configured with both Photoshop and Lightroom already ready to go in the software, so you don't have to worry about those two programs. Now that we're in Lightroom, let's take a look. If I click on exposure, then I can turn up and down the exposure very easily. If I click on this, this is contrast. Just like that, you see that? So you can move very quickly back and forth by using a combination of this wheel right here. What you use is you use the side of your finger. So you're kind of going like this, you see that? Just like that. And then you can kind of use your thumb to trigger these other buttons. You know what, I want to adjust contrast. I want to adjust exposure, like that. Then you've got these one-shot buttons here. If I tick on that, that's blacks. I can turn down or up the blacks. Same thing with the whites, the highlights, the shadows, and so forth. So really, editing in Lightroom is a combination of using this main button here most of the time with your finger, and then ticking off some of these buttons to do other things. I also assigned a shortcut to these two buttons right here to flip back and forth quickly from Develop Module to Library Module. See that? Boom. Boom. Pressing down on this scroll wheel pops up this menu here, which you can then choose a color, say your reds. Click on it, you could choose luminance, saturation, that sort of thing. And then once you do that, you can rotate this wheel to affect your reds. Then you press down on it again, scroll down, here's your blues. Turn this wheel, now you have your blues, see? Now let's flip over to Photoshop. I have the heel tool. I can just do this with my finger and change the size, and then tune this by zooming in. See that? Have a look at that. You see that? Pretty cool. And then you can go all the way back. It really works with Photoshop better than any other software application. Much better than Lightroom. In fact, I prefer using it with Photoshop than I do Lightroom. You can change different menu items by clicking the preset buttons. Like for example, here's the brush, here's the clone stamp, and then I could make the clone stamp large or small. So boom, click the button, choose the brush, make it a certain size, then you could zoom in, and you're good to go from there. One of the biggest benefits of using Tourbox with Lightroom was that I was able to keep my eyes on the image while I was making an adjustment. I wouldn't have to quickly look over at the slider and then look back. Being able to actually see the image adjusting as I'm staring at the image the entire time and not have to worry about where I'm clicking on those sliders, that was actually a lot better than I thought. Now, while I found some of the shortcuts helpful, other things about this were lacking for me and my style of workflow. For example, I would have liked to have been able to assign a shortcut button to a specific Lightroom preset. Press button, preset applied. If there was a way to do that, I just couldn't figure it out. Also, I would love to be able to assign the ability to switch from one film simulation to another, or toggle through the various film simulations with the control unit. When I did test it in Photoshop, I found that it was absolutely outstanding with dealing with brushes and quickly zooming in on the screen, and it really did speed up my Photoshop workflow as well. I have not tested this out on Final Cut Pro or any video editing program. Not a large percentage of my audience uses Final Cut Pro on a daily basis, so I didn't want to dig much into that for this video. I did have two main issues with this product. The first, although it's very solid, and I love that, the main control wheel feels thin and flimsy. I get that they had to make it thin and flimsy because when you are using your hand and turning it, you're just using the edge of your finger, so it needs to be. I get that. The dial should be removable because I would not pack this in a travel bag. I would be afraid this dial would actually break off while traveling. The second thing is that I would like to see an ability for presets to include more macro commands. reconfigure a button to apply a Lightroom preset, or to tell a specific button to export to Instagram while another button export to a TIFF file, or configure two buttons to switch between Provia and Acros FilmSim, or even open programs outside of Lightroom. For example, open Spotify and begin to play something. Maybe you can do it with this thing, but I couldn't figure out how. So in my little world, it doesn't do that. Also, I noticed that the unit got smudged pretty easily, but nothing that a quick wipe with a cloth couldn't fix. All in all though, this is one of the better built and best installation documented controllers I've ever used, especially the software. I look forward to seeing what they come up with in a version 2.0. I definitely think that this dial needs to be removable for travel. I'm gonna give the Tourbox a B+. Well, that's all for today. I am in the middle of lesson number 2 for Capture One, that is actively being created as we speak. Other videos are coming, including more review videos soon. In the meantime, if you found this video helpful, don't hesitate to give it the like and subscribe, and I will see you again in another video real soon. Take care.